Okay, this question is for topic two, assignment four. Yeah, so for those of you who are having problems with this question, right, just pay attention. Okay, if you like it, you can subscribe to the video. So the idea here is that we have to find the rational numbers A and B for which the solution of the equation is as follows. So we basically need to find so-called the value of X. Okay. So if you are bothered by this question, let me just ask you very intuitively, right? If you see actually this and this are what we call like the like terms, right? We want them to be together. Or let me just give you an example. If I ask you to solve something like this, right? 21x, instead I take away all the square root signs, I just put 2x plus 6. Right? Intuitively, what will you do? Now you know that you're just probably gonna put take 21x and 2x and put them together, right? Huh? So that's probably what you will do. And the thing is, well, if you're looking at this, right, then you also know that basically these two terms, we can also put them together. It's only thing is we can't so-called combine them and do operations yet lah. Okay, so with that, I'll just go straight to the question itself. So the first step, what we want to do is to combine the two terms that contain x side by side. So I have x square root 21 minus x square root 2. And I'm going to bring my square root 7 over. So this is square root 7 plus square root 6. Okay. And the next thing is you basically factorize out your x because you want to make x the subject, right? And eventually you want to solve for x. So you want x to be the subject. And with that, you can actually get your answer out very quickly. If you make x the subject, then you have x here. Okay, so with this, I think you are quite close really to getting your answer, right? So solving for x is not difficult. You have square root, you probably need the, you recognize that there's a conjugate in your denominator. And you need to push out the conjugate of your denominator to your terms here in order to rationalize your denominator, right? So this portion, we push out the conjugate. So after that, 7 to 21, this will be square root of 147. 7 to 2, this will be square root 14. 6 to 21, this will be square root of 126. 6 to 2, this will be square root of 12. And your denominator basically is just a minus b, a plus b. That will give you a squared minus b squared, which is 21 minus 2. Okay, so take note that because, okay, you see, if you're working at the endpoint, right, you look at endpoint, the endpoint is basically a coefficient of 14, square root 14, and square root 3. So if you're looking at your x now, ideally, you should be able to simplify it such that you basically have terms only containing square root 14 and square root 3. So if you look at this, right, you try to think of whether I can simplify it to a multiple of cert 14, or multiple of cert 3. Okay, so if you look at your x, square root 147, well, just try, you add 7 plus 4 plus 1, you can see this divisible by 3. And in fact, this is just 49. It's actually, this whole portion here is actually just, square root 49, square root 3, which is the same as 7 square root 3. So I'm just going to write square root 147 as 7 square root 3. Square root 14 will be by itself. So this is here. This is here. Now square root 126. I just want to bring to your attention, okay, that square root 126 can also be written as, it's also a multiple of 3. Is it multiple of 3? Yes, it's a multiple of 3. Or in fact, it's a multiple of 14. 1, 2, 2. It's a multiple of 14. So I can write it as square root 14 times square root 9, okay, which is the same as 3 square root 14. So this itself is the same as 3 square root 14. Okay, and square root 12, I mean, quite a familiar, it can be written as 2 square root 3. If you do not know this, please go and figure out. I'm not going to teach you in this video. Then once you are here, you can see that I'm very close to my endpoint. My endpoint is to get things that contain cert 14 and cert 3, right? So, square root 14, square root 14. If you combine them together, you get 4 square root 14. Square root 3, square root 3. If you combine them together, you get 9 square root 3. Now, combining these together and you are almost done. So just spread out the cert. I mean, just split up the cert. And there you go. You have your A and B. Okay, so this is your A and this is your B. Okay, and that's all for this question.